Whether you like New York style, Chicago style, Neapolitan, Sicilian, thick crust or thin, everybody loves to eat pizza. But do you know how to make the perfect pizza pie? It's harder than it looks. Step one, know your ingredients.
What are good ingredients?
Here at Max's Coal Oven Pizzeria in Atlanta, not only do they serve up incredibly tasty pizza pies, they even host pizza making classes. And as the executive chef says, the best pizza starts with the best ingredients, like fresh mushrooms and garlic.
Very woodsy, with a note of fungi.
Real pepperoni, fresh cheese, and oh, those tomatoes.
Can I have a vat of that to go? That's really good.
But before those delicious ingredients go on top, you must prep the dough like a true pizziola.
At this point, we're gonna pick it up. Go ahead and pick it up and hold it in two in your hand, so you wanna get a nice pinch around the crust. And we're just gonna pull the edge. See how I'm pulling the edge?
Yeah.
Like maybe just a couple inches at a time. Pull there.
Okay.
And it's gonna get larger. We're not gonna worry too much about the middle of the pizza. We're just gonna stretch the crust.
Now, how did you learn how to do this so well? That's
years.
A long story.
Yeah, years. I mean, I've worked in pizza restaurants pretty much my entire life. So.
Now, did you develop this technique yourself over the years?
Is this patented? Is 100% my own 12-step process.
I like it. Now, worst case scenario, what if I have bubbles in it or it's uneven?
That will become character when you cook it.
Character! I like it! I like my pizza full of character. Like my people and my pizza full of character.
Then you cup your hands and push the dough up against it to make the perfect crust.
Like I've been doing this for years.
That's right.
Now, the part you've been waiting for.
What do we see?
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie.
That's amore.
Amore.
Everyone!
Everybody sing!
No, not my terrible singing, my terrible tossing.
Like, oh, this looks advanced.
It's not that bad. We're gonna put this on the back of our knuckles.
Okay.
Okay? And we're gonna start we're gonna skip the middle and we're just gonna work on the edges. See, so I'm starting to pull that apart.
I am so afraid I'm gonna rip this beautiful pizza pie in half.
You're not gonna rip it in half. And if you do, you get more practice. All right, now then just turn it 90 degrees.
Oh, right.
You can do it, you can do it. You just want to start in the middle.
Yeah.
Stretch it.
Stretch.
And then turn. Now mine's, mine.
I know this is gonna sound silly. Tell me if this is gonna sound so ridiculous. Are you going counterclockwise? I know that's just.
If you're left-handed, you go counterclockwise.
I know it.
That is a lie. It doesn't matter. You just go any direction that you feel comfortable with.
I got this.
And now give it a flip, just one of these.
Shenanigans!
Getting the hang of this.
All right, one, two. You guys have to cheer for me no matter how bad it is. Ready? One, two, three.
Okay. Hey! Done! Get one of those.
Oh, I totally got this.
Yes. Excellent. Yes.
Okay, go again. Let's do a
this thing's getting thin.
I know. All right. 101, 102, 103.
104.
All day, baby, all day. All right. Oh my God, right in my face.
You're gonna wear that like
it's
a hat.
It's all funny games.
I did not see that coming.
Do not try this at home.
Now, for a pizza you'd actually want to eat, here's the rest of the lesson. About 3 handfuls of cheese go on first so the dough doesn't get soggy. Then you ladle on the sauce, but only in the Max's method, of course.
There's a little bit of a trick to this, okay. And that is whenever I ladle this on, I just kind of want to go in a spiral, and I want to get it as evenly distributed as possible.
Then, time to top it. I'm going with the time-honored tradition of the happy face.
I'm gonna give him a weird nose, first of all. Let's do that. Let's do eyebrows.
And now, time to bake it all up in the 1,000 degree oven. So following directions at this stage is highly recommended.
So when I do this, I'm just gonna angle the front of the peel down. Once this pizza starts to touch the deck, the actual bricktop deck, I'm just going to move the actual peel away from it and the pizza's gonna stay in place.
Cool.
Ideally.
Okay. I'm gonna watch you do this first.
One, two, three.
Nice.
Easy, easy.
And apparently there's kind of a jousting technique involved here.
There's a, yes, there's a jousting
technique.
Okay, ready?
Here, let's do it together. Ready? One, two, three.
Yep.
One, two, three.
Done.
Ta-da!
Whoa!
Then you just wait a few short minutes. Only a true pizziola knows when it's ready. There's no timer here. Once the edges start to proof up, as they say around here, time to turn it.
With my fingers.
Use your fingers.
And I want to flip it around to the back to see if the back side is kind of
There's some character.
We put it back in to finish and then.
Ready? Too hot to handle. The masterpiece.
Whoa.
Pepe the pizza is born. Ta-da! Is this the greatest pizza you have ever seen in your entire life? Look at this. And I plate it like a pro. And then I go like this.
Well done.
But just don't touch that part.
Now all that's left to do is eat. Mom and shop.